Next, we know the presidential election is often ripe fodder for comedians and late-night TV. But this year, you might say, is a little different. The campaign season brought Seth Meyers, who cut his teeth as a head writer at Saturday Night Live, to Washington this week, where he's been hosting his late-night program for NBC. Jeffrey Brown joined him at the Warner Theater.
When you said, it's technically really just the same furniture in a different place.
You even brought your own desk.
My own desk, yeah. When a man hosts a show, he builds a relationship with the desk, and you can't just, you know.
Not just
you
any
can't be
desk.
Promiscuous with the desk. You have to be loyal to one desk. So, yeah, we brought it down.
Good evening, everybody. I'm Seth Meyers. This is late night. We're in Washington, D.C. Get closer look.
The nation's capital, a destination, Seth Meyers told me, that fits with the DNA of his show.
He thought it was totally normal to just start walking off the stage while Hillary was giving an answer. Where is he going? What's back there, the ash heap of history?
Biting, direct, sometimes using raw language, Meyers' monologues have become increasingly political.
Barack Obama was born in the United States, period.
Obama was born in the United States, period. F*** you, exclamation point.
Targeting Donald Trump in particular. When we met in the Warner Theater last Friday, just before the leak of the 2005 Access Hollywood tape, I asked about the daily focus on Trump.
Well, it's really because of what he's doing. You know, we're not going out and sort of, we don't feel like we're making ad hominem attacks on him and just every day saying, we gotta find something on him. It's, you know, it's on the front page of the paper every day. You know, we do feel pretty strongly about everything. You know, I feel like comedy these days, particularly, is allowed to have a point of view. I think there was.
What do you mean these days, as opposed to?
Well, I think when you go back to Johnny Carson, I think there was a real sense that you didn't really know exactly what he felt, and Jay Leno, you didn't really know exactly what he felt. And I think that for that era, those guys were making the right decision. Now, you know, there's so many shows like mine. There are shows that I think live a little bit more by that Carson model, and then there are shows like mine that can, thanks to Jon Stewart's Daily Show, thanks to the Colbert Report, like we can live in a world now where people tune in and they do want to know what we're thinking, and we've certainly taken advantage of that this election.
What a great time to be in Washington. The Nationals won yesterday. The Redskins won yesterday. And the Orange Skin lost.
Traditionally, to entertain, to make us laugh,
yeah.
to help us end the day, to help us go to sleep, right?
Sure.
Okay? But that's not what you're doing.
Yeah, I mean, we want to be informative, and we want to talk about issues that we care about and we also think other people care about. But we really, I can't stress enough, if we can't get enough jokes in them, we will cut it that night. Like, we have to also be entertaining.
Yeah, but I watch. I mean, I see that there's a lot of jokes, but there's also a lot of very serious what you could call political analysis in it.
I would say we try to explain with jokes, and probably some analysis comes out every now and then. I don't know if I would take it to the bank, though. You should back up everything you see on our show with another source.
Oh, you're not going that far.
No,
trust everything we say. Right?
I will say we try very hard to be fair,
yeah,
as far as what we present, as far as being factually correct. I'm sure people, I'm sure there's plenty of people who watch my show that don't think we're fair at all because we hold a contrasting point of view to what they have. And I think that I completely respect and they are entitled to that position.
Do you think or do you want to influence people in this election? You clearly support one candidate over another. At least that's the appearance.
I think if you go back, like, we have not been particularly supportive of Hillary Clinton.
How many emails does Hillary Clinton have that she can just miss 15,000? Oh, no. Is she one of those weirdos who has them unread on her phone?
But we've certainly been harder on Donald Trump. I don't think in comedy support is a particularly funny position to have. I think it's far more... It's far funnier to point out people's flaws as opposed to pointing out their strengths. This is an election where one has so many more flaws than the other that it's naturally drawn our focus to that.
But conversely, have you ever felt that you wanted to go a little easier on Hillary Clinton because you were afraid of pushing people toward Trump?
I really don't think we have that kind of influence, so I really haven't thought about it that way.
You don't think you have that influence?
I don't think we have that influence.
But what about when most every late-night host seems to be taking off after Trump night after night?
We've barely scratched the surface of his scandals.
When Jimmy Fallon served up a more traditional, friendly late-night interview with Trump, sharp criticism came from another late-night host, Samantha Bee.
NBC tacitly condoned a race-baiting demagogue.
Some commentators, including New York Times columnist Ross Douthat, are critical of a late-night echo chamber and note a feeling by Trump supporters of, quote, being suffocated by the left's cultural dominance.
We try very hard not to be an echo chamber, and I hope people don't take us as that. And I really do respect the fact that for some people, my show might be frustrating for them to watch based on what they believe in, and I respect those beliefs. But again, I don't want to have to try to change my show to something I don't believe in. And again, you know, there's so many options for people to watch television right now. There's so many places to go. Take away the fact that you might not like any of your late night options that given night. People are, I'm sure, just going to Netflix and watching some documentary.
Or just go to sleep.
That's our biggest competition. Don't ever think that it's not sleep.
You are, of course, in a ratings business.
Yes.
Have you seen any impact of what you're doing in this election?
We haven't.
You have not?
We really haven't.
So you don't get any pressure to tone it down or?
No. It's hard to say. This is a complete hypothetical because we haven't seen anything. I mean, I would assume that if our ratings plummeted based on anything we were doing, the network would politely let me know.
They would.
Yeah. And they have, I can tell you up to this point, they haven't. And they have my number and they know where my office is.
They know how to reach you.
Yeah.
Seth Meyers, thank you very much.
And thank you for having me in the coolest bar in Washington, D.C.